The previous session was sufficient. Okay, we
Yeah.
have not done anything till now in this particular page. It's clear, right? The first task before going to the second, what we call second topic. Okay, you guys have to do one more important thing. Okay. Akshay, Tushar, Suresh, whenever you get the time, please do it. Okay, it's very important. I'm not talking only about the validation things. It's the practical thing which you have to think on that as well. For example, the requirement is what? I'll type it here so that just go through it and do it. Just take an example for this sign up form. Okay.
Okay.
I'm putting one radio buttons on the top. Means I'm just writing. Okay, two radio buttons on the top. Okay, the first would be, for example, policy one. The second would be policy two. Two radio buttons. You have to use it on top of that. The first name, last name, email, and password confirm. Because I have not shared with you any other thing. That's why I'm considering these fields. Okay, for now, you have to use two radio buttons on the top and give the text as a policy one, policy two. My requirement is what? I'll share with you. The first requirement is if the user or the client selects the policy one, then no validation should fire on last name. I'm just giving one field. That's it. No validation should fire on last name. But it should be policy two. I'm selecting a policy one in that case. So whatever the message I am getting, for example, run it now. If suppose that I have selected a policy one, okay, and I entered first name, last name, but it should okay. Validation. Okay, I have given a validation for every field right now. I entered my name, Ashwin. Okay. I have not entered in the last name. I entered XYZ. Okay, something. I clicked on create account. See, it is throwing me an error. Last name is required, but my requirement was if I have selected a policy one, then it should no validation for the last name.
Okay.
If I select a policy two, then the last name is required for that.
So sir, वो जो code लिखा है आपने, जो हम लोग ने इसपे, तो हम लोग just if else डालके वो check कर सकते हैं ना? If radio button policy one is selected, then show करना है. Otherwise else.
See, till now I have not written in a C sharp code right till now. Okay, the first thing. The second thing is, don't put any logic on the radio button until or unless there is no database call or server call. Okay? For example, what I have given, put a two radio buttons, policy one, policy two. User selects a policy one. No validation should be fired on the last name and policy two. Means I'm talking about once the user click on create account. Okay. In that case, last name validation should not fire. If somebody wants, instead of using the create account button, if wanted to write some code on radio button itself, for example, there is a radio button. For example, there is a radio button, I have used it. Okay. I have given a text as policy one. Where it is? what I did? Oh, sorry. I used a radio button list actually. The radio one. A radio button. For example, this is a policy one. Just consider this way. Policy one. If you don't want to go for the policy create account button, that's really good. When the user select a policy one, you need to double click on it. You will write a code for that. But what you need to do, you need to disable the required field validator on the last name. Got it? And on the policy two radio button, you need to enable it. Correct? So how can you do that? You have to do it from your end. Okay. But I'll tell you the property. And I'm expecting you can do it. Okay. For example, this is the required field validator. See, there is a call enabled. See, enabled equals to true. If I disabled this, okay, it will not work. Can we do it right now? See that. I disabled it. Might be there would be some enable client scripting, not. Let's try that first. Am I getting a last name? See, validation is not coming. If I have not entered anything till now, create account, see, it was disabled. When the user selecting the policy one, in that case, the text, the required field validator gets automatically disabled the required field validator for the last name. But for the policy two, you have to enable it. Got it? Why I have policy one, policy two? See, for example, right, I'll tell you one scenario. Companies, if they have some standards, like they have created one design form. Okay, for example, hotel, you are going for a booking of hotel. Yes, sir. Yes, Tushar, you're telling something?
No, sir.
Okay, okay. See, the requirement is why, where it can fit it. I'll tell you that thing. For example, you are going for a booking a hotel, okay, on the website. Yes, sir. Suresh, telling something? You are going for a booking a hotel room for 2 days or 3 days. Okay. So once you go to their website, okay, they have some policies. Policies means what? They have a policy means if the person is having a corporate card, okay, in that case, they should not provide a PAN card to me. Means they have, there's no need to require, there's no requirement for entering the corporate card. Based on the policies, they are setting the validations on the control. If he's not a corporate guy, then what he will do? He has to specify the PAN card over the drop text box. So based on the policies or criteria, you need to enable or disable the required field validators. It's not, we are not going for the client server side and all those things. Okay. If you remember, we all did in Windows application, we are checking if textbox 1.txt equals to empty, or if string dot is null or empty textbox 1, then we were displaying message box dot show first name is required. That's a totally server side. Now, this is totally a client side description. Okay. See here, it is loading. Loading means going to the server, clicking onto the create account. See, it is, even though this is a button, it is a server button, but it is not going to the server because it was initially it is blocked by the client side validations. If I entered it, if the client side validation things are okay, then it should go with other part. One, two, three. Now it will go to the server. See. Loading is going there. So you need to do that one for me. got it? And I'll ask you after 2 or 3 days to make one simple project, okay? Very simple project, design something. If you want, I can show you right now. No, I'll tell you how to do that, then you can do it. We did just today morning, okay, for someone, okay, here with you also. Let's with go with the other part. Now, I'm going to the login.as page. You can apply the validation controls here itself. Okay? Required field validator or whatever we have. Requirement is when I click on the login, it will generate some events. The button click, which we already have in Windows application. Same thing, same concept, everything is same here. Now, try to understand few things. The first line I am writing, writing in the bold letters, okay, just for to remember you guys. HTTP. I can make it as ASP.NET. Is a stateless what does it mean? Anyone have any idea on this? If you heard something, please share. HTTP is a stateless protocol. Means what? Akshay, any idea? Because in many locations you will find these things. Everybody has mentioned stateless is ASP.NET. HTTP is a stateless protocol. Why they have mentioned it? Don't go for theoretical knowledge. Do some practical so that it would be clear to everyone for entire life. This is the partial class. Okay, let's create one variable here. String. My name. I'm just writing name. Okay, it's a variable. Always try to make a habit whenever you're declaring a variable, you have to values, the default values. Okay. I'm placing a breakpoint here itself, and here itself. It is not going. New breakpoint is going to the function only. Here, yes. Now let's run it. This is the sign up form. Okay. F5. Where it is coming? Tell me. String name, string str, string dot empty. F10. Then it should go to the page load event. That's true. Let's assign this value name equals to hello. If you wanted to print something, so I have to write a keyword. There is a class response. It is inheriting from the page dot response. Actual class is HTTP response. So, if you wanted to write something onto the page, you have to use response dot write. I'm just specifying str value or what. Here I have make it on double click. I'm writing the name variable. Name is the global variable, right? Where it is going? It is going to the page load. Before page load, it is going to the class. Just remember these things. It is going to the class. not going to the page load. Into the class, then it will go to the page load event. This is the default event of the page lifecycle. Initially, we do have pre-init, but most of the times we are using a page load events. Okay. Let's enter some values. Something. Test. Password is 123 and the password is 123. Let's create. Click on create. So you guys tell me, I have launched this application. Once I initiated it, it went to string name equal to this. It went to the page load name equals to hello. Still application is running. So we should get the, when I click on the create account, I should get the value, correct? Or no? Sorry, you tell me first. Will I get the value or no? Initially, it went to here, class site, then it went to page load. I assigned a value here itself. The application was still running. I clicked on button create account. The value is getting assigned here. I'm writing 123, 123. Click on create account. See, hello is coming. Got it. Why? Because that was the HTML. That's why it is coming. Yes, right. Okay. On create account. See, hello is coming, right? Just try to understand few things. Okay. Click on here. Click it here. Click it here. 123, 123. Clicking onto the create account. When I press refresh, it always will go into the class side, class level. Then it will go to the respective event. Now it is going there. Right? If I click something, button or any action, if I'm passing it, 123, 123. If I'm clicking create account, still it is going to the string name equals to empty. Means whatever the value you have set it into the previous request, it was resetted by empty. Correct? That means data is not maintained at client side or the server side. We did in the console application or Windows application, we created a SQL connection class and created some variable that would be like available for all the button clicked. The value will be available there. But here, in the ASP.NET, whenever you make a request, it always go to the class level first. Whatever the variables, the objects you have declared, gets refreshed everything. The previous request, on the previous request which you have used for setting the value of the variable, you will not get it there. Okay, so that again it is setting a name equals to hello. Should I write every time for name hello assigning of again and again? Because HTTP protocol, HTTP is a stateless protocol. State is not maintaining at the server side nor in the client side. Whenever I talk about client side, means browser. Just consider layman language. This is the browser. This is the client. We talk about server. Just consider this is a server side code. That means it's a server. It is being deployed on some server. Okay. So that is why we call as a stateless protocol, because the data will not maintain at subsequent request or the multiple request. Got it? Any questions? Any doubt? A अक्षय एनी डाउट और तुषार?
नो सर।
ग्रेट।
बट डू दैट डेटा हैज एनी काइंड ऑफ एक्सपायरी टाइमिंग ऑन द वेब?
डेटा एक्सपायरी फॉर व्हाट अक्षय?
Suppose that variable name equal to hello, till what, how much long time it would be there?
It will
would be on like
never be there. Okay, I'll tell you. See, in the ASP.NET, what happened? That is why the MVC came into the picture. Because whenever you make any request, any server action, the previous data will get lost. Okay. If you until okay. You will not go some other mechanism, for example caching or cookies and all those things. I'm not going into these parts right now. Okay, we'll do that. Okay, but for now, okay. Why we are calling an ASP.NET is a stateless protocol, because whenever the client makes a request to the server, so whatever the data he has loaded, it will not be maintained. You have to recollect it from the database itself, then you will be able to do that.
Yeah.
Because every request it is going to the class, means in the class level, whatever the objects you have created, it will again reinitialize it, correct? For example, if you are talking about the data set on the class level, you have to specify data set, something like, correct? So whenever you make a request, data set will automatically gets refreshed. Data will not be there. Problem here it is, do you really need it to call this particular name, assigning a variable value hello again and again? If I have already set it in the first request, why should I go again set it again to the name equals to hello? It should not be happening, right? First thing. And whatever the things you are writing in the page load event, it always gets called. On every, if you click on the button create, if you click on the radio button, see the radio button is there. It's a click on radio button. Yeah, this is also a major problem. Understand this one also. Few of the controls have a default action, right? If I have written a code for this thing, that's true, but it is not getting fired. In the drop down, once you start using the drop downs, it won't work here until or unless you have to specify some properties or the attributes. Means the first attribute we have to specify for the few controls. Whenever, see, there is a common thing, common sense, we have to use it from our end. If anything, any control is not responding, if not executing the server side code, we have to make in a practice. First, we'll check whether the auto post back property is being set it true or not.
It's okay.
Important to remember it every time. Now I have set it auto, because few of the controls have the default property auto post back equals to true. Auto post back means a default action that should go to the server. Now let's run it again. Click on policy one. See, it is coming here now. In the same way, if I use a drop down list, it won't work. It will not fire any action until or unless you will not assign a auto post back property equals to true. Got it? Suresh, any questions?
No, I don't have.
Good. No question is very good question. Akshay, Tushar, Bala, any questions?
No, sir.
Okay.
Test वो is pushed back or is not pushed back वो checking वगैरह होता है वो
I'll come wait for some time okay don't worry because why I have shared you this string name equals to string dot mp the first thing name equals to it is going to the payload event correct okay fired the event auto post back and again if I am using this auto post back still it is going to the payload event okay let me tell you one thing which is very important it is going to the payload okay fine when I click on the policy one again it is going to the payload okay every time it is getting called assigning a name to hello every time I mean the previous data is already been lost correct now I'll come to you that is post back whatever okay for that okay. We will do it from tomorrow okay because of some reasons which before going to that you have to understand few more things okay then we'll go
okay,
no worry we'll have because that's very important without is not post back check you cannot do any application in the ASP.NET you have to use it anyway whether you write a code whether you don't write a code you have to write it okay means I'm talking about whether you write a business logic or you don't write it but is post check for the condition you have to mention it you have to specify it we'll come over there because along with that thing we will start the state management then you can understand why the is post back is required going to the see what you need to what you guys needs to do you have to apply the validations first you have to check a login from the database itself got it you guys already knows how to create a connection SQL connection how to write a query for select star from I'll do it from my end don't worry okay I'll do it but before the tomorrow session you have to go through it how we have created a connection and all those things okay right now I'm giving you something different I'll do it the login and sign up from my end also but you have to make a practice from your side I'm just giving you one example for file upload I am sharing this thing because we have to use it tomorrow this part now then my requirement is there is a sign up page for example and you wanted to upload a image okay so what I'll do I'll just create label here for specifying the text like profile I'll give you some assignments on that from tomorrow onwards on daily basis okay select profile there is a control called file upload okay next requirement is whatever the image you are going to select I want to display it somewhere I just drag an image control here I'm not using for the designing purpose right now just let's do that okay there is a button called upload we'll use this thing tomorrow okay so before coming for the next class you have to make a practice for this is the upload okay the button is btn upload I'll start asking you I'm clicking onto the upload just set this page as file upload this page as set as choose a file I can select any file open I want to show that particular file or the image here itself. When I click on upload, okay, what I have to write it. First thing, on the double click of the button, you have an event, you can just double click here itself. You can get the same code. Now, what is the control name which I have given it? This is a control we call as file upload one. You can give anything, okay? I am doing, just see. If file upload one, whatever the control name you have given it, dot, there is a property called has file. It will return true or false, whether you have a file or not. Okay. If you have selected the file, need to save this file where in the server. This is my server. So let me create one folder here, profile images or images. I wanted to save that particular file, the image here itself. It's not related to image, it can be anything, PDF, document, Excel sheet, video files, anything. I'm going to save this file, file upload one dot. There is a method called save as, in the bracket, string